Hi! How hot is the heating element in a toaster? It is obviously very hot, but how hot exactly? I don't have a thermometer that can measure as high as the temperature of glowing hot metal. But I do have a spectrometer that can measure the light coming from the glowing metal. Blacksmiths have known for centuries that there is a link between the glow and temperature of a metal. Maybe I can use the modern theories of blackbody radiation and high tech of a spectrometer to determine the temperature of the toaster. Or is the simpler blacksmith method of just use your eyes better? Let's find out. Don't toast yourself on mains voltage or hot surfaces. Metals start to visibly glow when they get really hot. Technically, their emission goes from only low-energy photons in invisible infrared at low temperatures to higher-energy photons in visible light at higher temperatures. And according to Wien's displacement law, the peak in the light spectrum can tell us the temperature of the object, at least for a theoretical blackbody radiator. In the real world, a grey body radiator, like the bright tungsten wire in an incandescent light bulb, is a close match. So I'll practice on this one before trying the much dimmer toaster. Now, the mains in my house is rarely the full 230 volts needed to make this lamp glow fully hot at 60 watts. At the time of recording, it was a dreary 217 volts and 54 watts. Let's capture its spectrum on the spectrometer. Okay, the shape is not a perfect match to any blackbody temperature, but let's find the peak of the spectrum. Around 650 nanometers in visible red. That equals a temperature of 4,500 kelvins. That can't be right. While tungsten does have the highest melting point of any pure metal, it would still turn into a liquid at 4,500 K. Not a great start. A more realistic approach is to simply take the color temperature of the incandescent light bulb, likely 2700K for this old generic one, or around 2450K at only 54 watts. At least we can see how the peak does shift towards shorter wavelengths and how the intensity does increase as the lamp gets hotter and therefore brighter, following Planck's and Wien's law. How about another incandescent lamp type that is known to run even hotter? A halogen lamp. This 70 watt halogen is a bit over the top for my 60 watt light dimmer. Especially since it seems to be more like 75 watts. But for a short run, it should be fine. The marketing department also seems to get the color temperature wrong. Halogens are only more efficient when they, due to the halogen cycle, can run hotter than ordinary incandescent lamps, giving halogens a color temperature of typically 3000K, not 2700K. Will the spectrometer confirm that this halogen lamp is running hotter? Yes, this is good. The halogen peaks at 623 nanometers on the spectrometer. That equals 4700 kelvins, 200 more than for the ordinary incandescent. Maybe this halogen has a bit warmer white color temperature of 2900K at full power after all, instead of the standard 3000K for halogens I assumed. Interesting. This info could be useful for estimating the temperature of the toaster using this spectrometer. Subtract roughly 2000K from the estimation based on spectrum peak to get a more realistic actual temperature. Here's my old flatbed toaster, the Family Toaster 700. Toast your family at 700 watts. Well, actually only 585 watts, with the mains voltage dropping to 211 volts. Yikes! The heating elements in the toaster are not very bright compared to light bulbs. But if I turn off the studio lights and tweak the spectrometer settings, I should be able to catch the spectrum. Here we go. Nice! This spectrum peaks in infrared, indicating a lower temperature than in the light bulbs. It peaks around 912 nanometers, equal to about 3180K, minus the offset from the lamps, that is 1180 kelvins, or 900 degrees C, within the realistic range based on other observations. I just don't like this steep drop in infrared above 930 nanometers. Looks like something is filtering the spectrum, possibly giving a false peak. Could be the opalescent quartz tubes encasing the glowing metal wire. If I put safety first, after the primary goal, I might be able to run the toaster without the quartz tubes. Give me a minute. Okay, gone are the quartz tubes. I love the effect opalescent quartz tubes have on light. Their strong highlights and silvery shadows seem to dramatically exaggerate the contrast of incoming light. Beautiful. The tubes were a major safety feature of the toaster, so don't try the following yourself, please. Notice how close the bare wires, conducting 230 volts, are to the metal case. And I expect them to droop even more from heat expansion once turned on. The wires are clearly magnetic at room temperature, attracted by the magnetized screwdriver. This indicates they are made of an alloy named ferrite, not the more expensive and arguably better nichrome alloy or tungsten. Now, I don't want the wires to short circuit to the metal case. All exposed metal on the toaster would conduct mains voltage and it would go directly to ground. The RCD would then cut the power and end my experiment. So I'll use the quartz tubes and a glass from a halogen work light to insulate the heating wires. By the way, don't use halogen work lights without their front glass. There's a genotoxic and carcinogenic reason. More about it in another video of mine. I don't fully trust this to work. I need to make sure I have proper grounding and RCD protection in this crazy setup. My house is so old that the sockets in the living room are ungrounded. Bummer. Running an extension cord from a grounded kitchen socket then, and verifying the grounding works. Yep, there is a full voltage potential between live and ground. After a short message, we will test if this setup works. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Will this crazy toaster modification work? I will of course treat it as if the metal grill can go electrically live at any time. Great, we are good to go. Is the spectrum different without the quartz in the way? No, not really. Brighter, yes, but the shape and peak positions seem unchanged. I can't explain this sharp dip above 930 nanometers then. Maybe the simpler, good old Blacksmith way is better. Just look at the color and brightness with your eyes. I found this chart online. Don't know how precise it is, but let's give it a try. While the toaster is running at a low 560 watts, I'll turn off the light to remove any light reflected off the quartz tubes. We only want to see the emitted light from the wires. Well, I am no blacksmith, but looking at the color tone alone, isn't the 900 degrees C square the closest matching, giving us the same result as from the spectrometer test? I feel pretty confident that the temperature of this toaster's heating elements at the low voltage in my house is close to a whopping 900 degrees C, even though I haven't measured it with any thermometer. While I go buy a new toaster, I hope you enjoyed this video enough to click like and perhaps subscribe for more like it. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.